And so, you know, we had obviously very ambitious goals for this film. And we knew from the get-go that we wanted to choose our video game partner very carefully. You know, we wanted market share, we wanted the technological horsepower of a major player, but we also wanted the personal touch. We wanted the creativity and the passion of a small team. And we found that at Ubisoft we got the best of both worlds, and it was the perfect balance. I met Giannis and his creative team in 2006, and they walked in with a pitch for a game whose themes beautifully mirrored those of the movie. They had all these great groundbreaking ideas, and they were all ready when they came to pitch to us, totally inside the head of the movie and Pandora, the environment, the Na'vi culture, and it was just wonderful to hear the ideas that they brought to the table. So I knew on the spot that we had found the right partner. Because they weren't people who simply wanted to put something flashy on the screen. They wanted a soul behind the video game. And they also brought, you know, the same passion and commitment to Avatar, I felt, which is a licensed game, that they brought to their own in-house creations. You know, and let's face it, you know, games derived from movies historically, you know, some of them have kind of sucked. And I didn't want Avatar, I didn't want anything associated with Avatar to suck. So, you know, I proposed to them this theory that the game should not be a slave to the movie. It should follow its own storyline. It should be developed fully in parallel so that they exist in the same world, you know, using the same creatures and the same environments, but that the game has its own stories. And, you know, Ubisoft rose to that challenge. They created new characters, vehicles, weapons, and they embellished upon the settings, and they also enhanced the way that the Na'vi interact with their creatures and with their world, their interaction with the plants, how they get their powers and their poisons, and they totally went off, and they brought so much extra detail to it. And we began the process very early, 2.5 years ago. So they had plenty of time to explore and develop the visuals. And this is usually where the whole game-movie interface breaks down, because movies are on a year, kind of year track, screaming to the theaters a year after somebody pushes the button. And it's just not enough time to do a game properly. So we got into this early. They've developed the game properly. It's a fantastic game. It's been a very collaborative partnership. You know, we gave the Ubisoft team access to all of our CG assets as we created them, and to our captured motion and to our animation. And when they said, hey, we really want to have a ground vehicle, we said, yeah, sure, design it yourselves. You know, they've created vehicles, they've created weapons. I've approved their designs. Sometimes we even had our own design team design vehicles for them that are in the game and aren't even in the movie. You know, a number of their design ideas have been incorporated into the film. I saw something great and I said, I want that in the movie. I want that particular treatment for the bioluminescence, for example. I encourage them to create their own settings, characters, vehicles, models, you know, the modes of conflict, you know, between all the characters, but all within this kind of rough outer boundary of the world that we had created. So they ran these new story threads and characters past me, and I found them to be, you know, pretty highly imaginative, but always consistent with the world that I had created. They also came up with the idea of allowing the player to choose either a Na'vi perspective or a human perspective. In other words, the good guys and the bad guys in this game are entirely a matter of the player's choice. I think that's really cool, and there are a number of thresholds throughout the game where you can make that choice. If you feel like you've made the initial choice incorrectly, you can switch sides further down throughout all the levels. It's really pretty remarkable. So this kind of moral theme, if you will, actually tracks beautifully to one of the main messages of the movie, which is, you know, to see and understand through others' eyes. Now, because Avatar was being made in 3D, I urged Ubisoft to consider authoring the game in 3D and presenting it to the world in 3D. And they kind of were a little dubious at first because of the technology and the time scale, but they came back very excited several months later, and they showed me a demo in stereo, which blew us away. And it was on. We were doing it. They made the commitment to make Avatar the first major stereoscopic title. So, you know, I believe that when entertainment succeeds in today's market, it does so by converging movies, video games, books, toys, graphic novels, online experiences to create this kind of greater universe in which you can visit and enjoy the settings and the characters in multiple ways. The story of the movie doesn't have to be retold in these other outlets, but there should be this sense of enlarging the world and enhancing the viewer's knowledge of the history and the culture and all of these things within that fantasy world. So the world of the Avatar game is in some ways considerably richer and more extensive than what you're going to see in the film. And at the same time, it doesn't contain any spoilers that are going to ruin the movie experience for you. And that allows us to put it on the street before the film comes out. So in a way, this is the perfect consonance between these two different media. You know, I set out with Ubisoft to create the ideal model, if you will, for how a game and a movie can be co-developed in parallel, with neither one kind of being the red-headed stepchild of the other. And I believe that we've done that. You know, Ubisoft challenged itself to set the bar pretty darn high. And they've taken on a project which was difficult, it was massive, it was technologically revolutionary, as much as the film. And, you know, they've invested in technology that's going to allow this to be the first major stereoscopic 3D title, you know, done from its inception. And, you know, we're all pretty passionate about making Avatar the coolest new game out there. And I could stand here today right now and tell you guys that Ubisoft have done it. In closing, I just want to urge you to get a look at the demo at their booth over the next 3 days. And because I got to play it today, the new demo. And it's pretty fantastic. You just kind of stick your head close into the monitor like this, and the world wraps around you. And I have to say, it's one of the first times in a video game that I actually was afraid. You know, when the hammerhead charges, when the viper wolves are attacking, and you're having to fend them off, it's pretty darn exciting. I think you're going to really like it. So thanks very much.